Hey guys, what's up? Well, making this video today, and I usually try not to get preachy in my videos, but I've had something going through my head for a couple days now, and yeah, we're going to look at the motor, but the motor kind of plays into it. So, yeah, let's get started. Bit jigs, okay. Well, as you can see, I've done a little bit of changing. I can't stand orange. I've said it before, I hate orange motors. So I just kind of got ahead of myself and shot the front of this motor black. Got the silver on the valve covers, and to me, that just looks fucking good. I'm not a big chrome guy. With the other stuff I'm going to be doing to this motor, I think it's going to be good. But I also started tearing into it a little bit, a few little things, you know. Looks like somebody put some epoxy in there, probably had a hole in it at one time, probably from somebody leaving antifreeze in it. And like has been said on other people's videos, when antifreeze gets old, it gets acidic. So if you got a car with antifreeze, change that shit out regularly, you know, because it gets acidic and it starts eating up aluminum, and that's what this is made out of, pot metal, aluminum, whatever. But I've got another timing cover, so that's no big deal. I'm going to pop that off. I was going to put a timing chain tensioner in it anyway, but yeah, there we got the motor, and that brings me to what I wanted to talk about in this video. Dealing with your bullshit. And it seems like a lot of people don't want to do that, you know. Okay, and that goes into everything. Dealing with your bullshit. What kind of car you want to run? I want to run this Duster because it's what I have. It's my bullshit. I can't do body work. I am not a body man. I'm not a trained body man by any stretch of the word. But guess what? I don't like the color red. I couldn't handle it. I have certain things, quirks. I don't like the color red. So guess what? I'm painting a car. It ain't going to be pretty. It's not supposed to be pretty. I'm dealing with my bullshit. I didn't want to spend all the money to tub this car out, but I ended up getting a set of big fucking tires cheap. So guess what? They're going to hang out the side because I like the way that looks. And again, because I don't want to go through and move inboard springs and mini tub and do a bunch of welding that I don't necessarily know how to do, I deal with my bullshit. When I first started building this car, it was going to be a small block car at the beginning. In fact, you can go back in some videos and some lives, and people ask me, and I said, yeah, it's going to have a 360 in it. I had a motor I was building. Well, that motor, the Magnum motors, I have to say that there is the least amount of parts out there, good speed parts for Magnum motors. Can't get good heads, can't get a lot of shit. So I decided, well, I'll just put together a 440 out of a motorhome. I should be able to find one of them. Looked around at my budget. Found one, was cool. It was going to be bought from a friend. It was awesome. But things happened. My daily truck broke down. I had no way to go transport the motor. Had to deal with my bullshit. Luckily, I had a friend that had a good running motor. He would be willing to sell me. And yes, sell. This motor was not donated by Jed. I paid for this motor. And once again, I'm not the kind of guy who's going to stop and give up. I'm going to be at the No Name Nationals with this car, going down the track, racing and having fun. I have never claimed that I'm going to be the fastest guy there, or I'm going to rotate the earth or anything like that. There's going to be a lot faster guys there, but I'm going to be there with this car in 130 something, 129, whatever, however many days there are. But I'm gonna be there with this car. This motor, I know, runs. I know that that's not a factory cam. I know that these heads have had quite a bit of port work done to them. You can feel it. You can feel it in it. If they've had a lot of work done to them. Now, I have also, I got a bore scope and I checked. Because I was thinking, you know, hey, got to know what kind of pistons are in it so I can know what to deal with. So I can know what bullshit I have to deal with. Well, here, let's take a look. I don't know if you can see that on camera. My little bore scope. But this is a pretty much factory flat, well, dish piston. You can see the ridge right there. Which, you know, okay. I know what it's got in it. Now I know I can't push the nitrous over 100, 150 shot without risking collateral damage that I don't want to do because I'm actually very happy with this block. And then we'll go into that here in just a second. Yeah, this is an 88 block or 88 casting number, a late 88. So it's an 89 block. It went into, let's say, an 89 pickup truck. These little guys right here. And if you look here, this block is a roller motor. They have flat tappet. And it's something a lot of people did. The flat tappet cams, are they used to make a lot more. They still make a lot different, a lot more, has a lot more selection than the roller, the factory roller stuff. But Hughes Engines now makes a lot of these roller cams. So when I do, after the No Name Nationals, decide to pull this motor out and go through it, yeah, I'll probably make a 408 stroker. I'll probably put forged pistons, forged crank, forged everything in it. I'll need a different cam. I'll need a different set of heads. That's not to say that between now and September, I might find a set of heads cheap on Marketplace. Then these are coming off and a good set of heads is going on it. Not that there's anything wrong with these heads, but I'd like to. Yeah, I'll get an aluminum set of heads. I don't care. I'd like to have an aluminum set of heads. But, you know, it happens. So, the block I'm very happy with, like I said. I have a good set of roller lifters that'll save me money on a future build. And save me break-in time. See, that's another reason I actually bought this motor. And this motor was such a good deal. I don't have to, I don't have to break in a cam. I don't have to do anything. Really, just put together what I'm putting together, dress up what I want to dress up, and drop it in the car. I don't have to buy special motor mounts that I would have had to buy with a big block. You know, so, would I have loved for it to have a $5,000 set of forged pistons in it? Yeah. Does it? No. Am I upset? Not in the least. I'm very happy because I know I have a running motor. And the other things that came with this motor and everything about this motor made it well worth the purchase price. Plus, it's saving me a lot of time and saving me money from my other endeavors. So, you guys out there running into problems, everybody is. I'm seeing it now, really starting to see it. People are running into problems. People are getting frustrated because it really seems like there's a lot of frustration out there now with these guys. We're not as happy as we were in the beginning, and we really need to be because that's what this event's about. It's about having a good time. That's what the whole thing is about. Everybody, chill out. Stop attacking each other. Stop saying, oh, I'm not going to go to the event. Because guess what? If you don't, you didn't want to go that much in the first place. So, deal with your bullshit. I hope you guys like this video. You got to see a little bit of the motor, a little bit of what I've been dealing with, my bullshit. And, you know, like I always say, like, share, subscribe. If not, I don't give a fuck.